Talks, the maiden venture by Brightland School, is a series of webinars to empower the young minds with skills and progressive thinking. Through this platform, we intend to connect with children of all age groups and their parents and deal with the questions of the inquisitive minds left unanswered so far.
Good evening, everyone. I am Rahul Bhardwaj, moderator of today's session on career counseling. We at Brightland School believe, just like the seed you plant with love and care, no matter how small, grows into a mighty tree. Similarly, if we want a future for ourselves, we must now care enough to create, nurture, and secure a future for our children. In today's post-pandemic times, the world is going through a major transition, and it is our moral duty to equip our young generation to face all the future challenges with confidence. In continuation of our series Kindling Talks, today we will be addressing one of the most crucial questions: what next for our students? And today we have Mr. Ritesh Jain to enlighten our viewers with the choice of career they can make based on their strength and abilities. Mr. Ritesh Jain, an alumnus of Harvard Business School, has been a leading aptitude trainer, motivational speaker, and career coach. Known for conducting live career helpline sessions on various national TV channels like Aaj Tak, Doordarshan, IBN7, and the list is too long. He has also been a personal mentor and counselor to over 30,000 undergraduates and over 10,000 postgraduates, including 512 in IIMs and 112 in many Ivy League universities worldwide. He has traveled to over 20 countries and delivered 600 plus guest lectures across the globe. The list is exhaustive and endless, and I'm sure all of you eagerly waiting to hear him. But before he takes on the stage, I would like my panelists to introduce themselves.
Good evening, everyone. I, Khushi Sharma of Class 12 Humanities, studying in Brightland School, is obliged to be a part of this talk show, and I'm eagerly waiting to grab the valuable information from the session. Thank you.
A very good evening to all. I, Anya Singh of Class 12 Commerce, studying in Brightland School, would like to extend my gratitude as I feel privileged to represent the school council in this encouraging session. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I am Abhimanyu of Class 12 Humanities, studying in Brightland School. I feel so excited to get this opportunity of attending the talk show. Looking forward to it. Thank you.
Warm wishes of the day. I'm Garvita Goyal of Class 12 Humanities, studying in Brightland School. And it's an honor for me to be a panelist for this talk show on career counseling. And I'm eagerly waiting to grab more information on this topic.
Thank you, Khushi, Anya, Abhimanyu, and Garvita. Now, without any delay, let us welcome Mr. Ritesh Jain, sir. Over to you, sir. Sir, I think mic is not working. Jain, sir.
Oh, I hope I am audible now.
I'm
very grateful to Brightland team, Rahul sir, Prashant sir, and the whole team that, you know, they keep giving me opportunity to meet these bright chaps, you know, and who are full of energy and enthusiasm. I'm sure they'll be having a lot of questions today as well. See, they are in standard 12th. That means they are in that juncture in their life, which is the most crucial. And in today's era, when we see that parents are, you know, forcing students to take mathematics, take biology, then become engineer and then become doctor, it is not that becoming engineer or becoming doctor is bad, but under force, it is not so good. If a student want to go for, let's say, humanities, and you say, no, humanities is something, you know, which is below our standard or something like that. So the times are changing now. And rather, we see a lot of good opportunities which are available for humanities students and commerce students, probably much more than that of those with biology or mathematics. So to start with, my suggestion to students is, please do not choose your career thinking that I need to get the best career. No, this should not be the case. Rather, you should focus on a career which is matching with your attitude, with your ability, with your aptitude, and so on. So it should be a game of matching. It should not be a game of selection. So I hope no one today is going to ask me what is the best career option available today. What is, you know, whether which branch of engineering is best. Nothing is best. It depends on you. You know, it is like the cap of my pen. If I lost the cap of my pen, I'm looking for my cap. I'm not looking for the best cap available in the market. So it should match. Your career should match your abilities. It should not be the best career available in the market, right? The second generally wrong question I would generally see in different forums, which is the most paid career, you know, where I would earn more. So please understand, there's nothing like paid career, and there is nothing like, you know, earning too much money because you choose the right career. If you send Lata Mangeshkar to play cricket or you send Sachin Tendulkar to sing, both of them would not earn any money, right? So please understand, money is byproduct of success. So unless you add value, you will not be successful, and hence you will not be rich. So if you want to be rich, you have to be successful. And if you want to be successful, you should think about how you can add value. And which are those places, which are those career options where you can add more value than your peers, right? So to select a career, we should not focus on what we'll be getting back. Rather, we should focus on what we can attribute, what we can add, right? So your ability to add value is the sole criteria for your career. I'm sure I'm going to have lots of questions. So I hope you made clear who is going to start.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Rightly said. Now let's open the session for our panelists. And sir, I request you to address their queries.
Sure.
So soon after the vote, students would be concerned about different career opportunities available. So please enlighten us, what are the career opportunities available for commerce and humanities students?
Okay. For commerce and humanities students, we can probably, you know, divide this into two different parts. The first is where the student want to go for a graduation, and then they will prepare for government examinations. And the second, when the students want to go for a corporate career option. So if you want to go for government job, then I would suggest you to go for a plain BCom or BA course from a good university like Delhi University or BHU or Jamia Millia or so on. Second is the corporate career. If you want to go for corporate career, there are certain options, like first and the top is management career option. So if you want to go for management, my suggestion to these bright kids is that you should focus on 5 years integrated program rather than 3 year program. The reason is, suppose if you want to join IIM Indore, if you do your graduation for 3 years and then you need to appear for CAT examination, which is very difficult to crack, where you have competition with all the IITians. On the other hand, if you prepare for IPM program, integrated program in management from IIM Indore or from IIM Rohtak, IIM Jammu, IIM Bodh Gaya, and IIM Ranchi. So these are the five top colleges in India which are providing 5 years integrated program. That means once you are getting selected for this course, you will be out with MBA degree. And you need not to go for CAT or any other entrance after 3 years. Second good career option within corporate is law. There are very, very good and bright colleges like NLS Bangalore, the starting salaries are more than 50 lakhs rupees per annum. And there are 20 NLUs, starting with Bangalore, Hyderabad, Bhopal, and till Ranchi and Patna. One more NLU, which is taking another exam, AILET. All these 20 colleges, which I said, they are through CLAT exam. Another NLU, which is NLU Delhi, it is taking separate exam, AILET. After this, you have Symbiosis option, you have Jindal Law College option, and then you have plethora of colleges. But if you get good college, then the placements are very good. If you get average colleges, then the placements would also be average. And therefore, my suggestion is to slog, work hard, and get the best college in the field you need to go. Third, of course, you can go after management and law. You can go for hotel management. You can go for journalism. You can go for hospitality management. You can go for fashion technology. You can go for interior designing, and so on. So in total, if we see, then I would say other than engineering, medical, commerce and humanities students are come every year. Now focus on why I generally say that humanities and commerce students have better chances of good future than science students. Why I said so? Let's take one example. What is happening is most of the good kids, they are forced to take science just out from their 10th standard. And therefore, what is happening is almost in every field, if you go and check who are the students who are getting selected after a competition, majority of them are engineers. And because of that, the good colleges like IIM Ahmedabad and IIM Indore, they are losing their world rankings. Why they are losing it? For two reasons. One, they have male to female ratio almost 10:1. Second, they have engineers and non-engineers ratio again 9:1. So to improve their rankings, they have started focusing on girls and focusing on humanities and commerce students. I'll give you an example. I had a student last year who was a boy, passed out from IIT Delhi. He scored 99.98 percentile in CAT. Yes, 99.98 percentile. IIM Ahmedabad has not given him even call for group discussion and personal interview. Now you must be wondering, if 99.98 percentile he's not getting call, who will get a call? Another girl, Shashti, she was a BCom student from Miranda House. She scored in CAT 89 percentile. How much? 89 percentile. And she received calls from almost all IIMs. The reason? Because she is the beneficiary for both. Number one, she got extra marks because of gender diversity, and she got extra marks because of academic diversity. So when you are very sure that you have to go for IIM Ahmedabad for your MBA, then I would suggest, rather than going for BTech for 4 years and then writing CAT, why don't directly you either you go for 3 years BCom or 3 years BA course and go and join IIM, where your percentile requirement is much lesser. Or probably even better is if you can actually go and write the exam for IPMAT, which is for integrated program in management. And therefore, once you got selected, you are in IIMs and you will be out after 5 years having MBA degree. I hope I have answered your query, Garvita.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
So I have a question. So what are the career options for science students other than medical and engineering?
Very good question. Now, certainly there are students, which as I discussed while answering Garvita, that there are some students who are forced to take science, but they are not exactly keen on engineering or medicine. Or earlier they were keen, and after taking maths or biology, now they feel that engineering or medical is not their cup of tea. So these students actually go for every option which I have discussed with Garvita. That means you can go for IPM, you can go for CLAT or AILET or SLAT or LSAT. That means you can go for 5 years integrated program in law. In fact, today there is a news that IIM Rohtak, which was anyway very famous for its IPM program, they have today launched their 5 years law program also. So since these programs are actually very, very successful, many more colleges are keep on, you know, starting those programs, and therefore you get more opportunities to join those colleges. Again, you can go for hotel management, you can go for journalism, you can go for, and of course, I did not discuss those government jobs in detail while answering Garvita. So I think this is the opportunity to focus on that. Any graduate, whether he or she is from humanities, commerce, or science, can go for government examinations. So what are these government examinations I'm talking about? The most prestigious one is UPSC, through which you can be an IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS officer. For that exam, the criteria is that you should be a graduate with minimum 50% marks in 12th standard, full stop. After that, they are not asking whether you should be from science or commerce or humanities, nothing. Any student who has got 50% in graduation can actually apply for UPSC. And if you actually crack the UPSC, you can be a DM of one city, you know, and the scope is endless. If you feel you are not that bright and you need government jobs which are not as high as IAS, then the second best option available is SSC-CGL, which is combined graduate level. Through this exam, again, the criteria is same, graduation with 50% marks. You can write this exam, and this exam will give you the opportunity to become income tax officer, GST officer, and almost officer grade in any government department. Almost all government departments have officer posts, and that is through SSC-CGL. If you feel that competition is very high, you could not even crack SSC-CGL, then the last option in government departments is to join government department as clerk. In most of the cases, the eligibility is 12th standard with 50% marks. In some cases, again, graduation with 50% marks. Exam you need to write for these posts is SSC-CHSL. So SSC-CHSL is focusing on clerk grade jobs in government departments. Other than government departments, you can go for bank, metro, railway, and many other semi-government concerns in India. So if you want to go for these places, generally they again have two entry criteria. For example, the government banks in India have two entry criteria. The first is SPO, or probationary officer. Eligibility criteria again is graduation with 50% marks. If you want to go for clerical, again, it is graduation. It is not 12th in the case of bank. In government jobs, it was 12th, but for banks, the entry criteria or the qualification is same for clerical as well as PO. The only difference is the exam you crack. If you crack PO exam, you directly would become officer, or if you crack clerical exam, you will become a clerk. So you can join any of these government jobs, and you can go for any of the career options we have discussed for in case of Garvita, or in case of humanities or commerce students. The same list is applicable for science students as well. Abhimanyu, have I answered your query, or if you have any other point, probably you can ask again.
Yes, sir. You have answered, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So my question is, what is the procedure of getting into DU in 2021, and how to prepare for DU entrance exam?
Very good question, because the whole world today is asking about what is CUCET. In fact, I checked this Google Analytics, and suddenly so many students are interested in CUCET. So what is the CUCET? The CUCET is not a new exam. CUCET is the exam which started in 2009. In 2009, it was only taken for 14 central universities. What are these central universities? Central universities are the best universities in India, which are directly under the control of central government, and therefore the fee structure is almost negligible. That means you get the best of the opportunities, you get the best of the faculty members, you get the best peer group, and the fee is minimum, almost negligible. So all these are the central universities. Only for 14 universities, it was being conducted from 2009 to 2020. But this year, what is different? This year, this exam, CUCET, is taking care of 54 central universities. That means all the top central universities in India, Delhi University, BHU, and all other universities are also coming under the ambit of CUCET. So different universities will have different weightage for CUCET and 12th standard marks. Though it is yet to be formally announced, but mostly from the sources, it is almost confirmed that 50% marks in your merit list would be given because of your board examination, and another 50% are through CUCET, right? So now the next question probably would be, okay, we understand what is CUCET and how it is going to happen, but what it contains, what would be the subjects? So again, there are two different papers in CUCET. For certain degrees like BBA or BMS, there would be only one paper of aptitude. While for other degrees, like for example, you go for psychology, BA psychology, or you want to go for BCom, or you want to go for any other specialized examination like pharmacy or engineering, there would be two different papers. First would be the aptitude test, and second would be the subject test. The subject test would be on the subject you want to pursue further. And the first, which is common for everyone, is aptitude test. So what is this aptitude test? This aptitude test would contain three different sections. The first section is for quantitative aptitude, which is almost 10th standard maths. Percentage, profit and loss, average mixture relegation, time and work, time and distance, and so on. Second is English. This English, again, would be almost 8th standard level. The only difference is you need to be fast enough to solve those. Most of the questions, that means 60 to 70% questions, would be on reading comprehension, which you have seen in school as unseen passage. The only difference is here, it would be slightly more critical. The options would be very similar to choose from, and the time consumption is very important. Other than this, there would be questions on vocabulary, that means synonyms, antonyms, analogy. Then there would be questions on grammar, sentence correction. The last but not the least is parajumbles. They'll give you one paragraph in four different parts, and then they'll name them A, B, C, D, and then they'll say what would be the better, you know, combination B, A, C, D, or C, A, B, D, and so on and so on. So this is the syllabus for verbal ability or English section. The third section is reasoning. Reasoning contains puzzles, and you have seen this coding, decoding, then blood relation. Your uncles, wives, sons, mom would be your what kind of questions. And then there would be questions on matching, then analytical reasoning type questions, and then circular arrangement type questions. Then there would be questions on visual reasoning. So all sort of reasoning where you need to choose the correct option out of the four. So these three different areas would be covering aptitude section of CUCET 2021. The good point is your preparation for CUCET, your preparation for banks, your preparation for SSC, they are very similar. And therefore, whatever you are preparing right now in 12th standard, it is not going to be wasted after graduation. Even if you are writing CAT exam, then also the syllabus is almost same. Anything else you want to know about CUCET or about the Delhi University entrance, Anya?
No, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Good evening, sir. Sir, my question to you is, can humanities students study at IITs?
Pardon me? Humanities students?
Study at IITs.
Yes, very good question. Because most of the students feel that IITs are all about engineering or technology. The answer is no. You actually can get MA English course or MA in social sciences course from IIT Chennai. And for that, the qualification is you should have 12th standard with humanities. So if you are a humanities student, if you are aspiring to go and join IIT, there are very good courses. These are very good courses available in IIT Chennai, and the exam, entrance exam you need to crack while going there is HSEE. So this HSEE exam, they again have two sections. The first section is focusing on quant and reasoning, and the second section is focusing mainly on verbal ability. So these are the courses where you can actually get the IIT brand name and the IIT placement. And for these courses also, IITs have very, very good placement support. The placement is 100% after their post-graduation in humanities courses. And I'm sure many other IITs also are going to join the wagon very soon. It was started with the IIT Chennai, and IIT Bombay mostly will start this kind of program this year or next year. And therefore, you can definitely go and join IIT, even if you have 12th standard you have done from humanities background. So I wish good luck to all you students. If you have any query, you can probably meet your school authorities, Rahul sir, Prashant sir, or anyone else, and you can get it clarified through me also. And I am very happy that the schools are taking this kind of responsibility, and they are arranging this kind of sessions. And I really feel that every school should start something like this, so that students should not be worried about their career guidance. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, sir. We are indeed honored to have you. And before ending today's session, I would like to thank you again for clarifying the doubts and guiding our young minds to pursue their choice of career. It was a truly igniting session for all of us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you so much, sir.